person with the Donna, and they get together and try to figure out the stories they want. Because that's why we carve totem poles, to tell a story. Because in the old days, we never had a written language on paper, so we had to tell the younger generations our stories. They could be for a mortuary pole. When I was young, there's another park further out north here. I saw the first replica of the old totem poles that were 200 years old now. And I was only 5 years old. I saw a box on the back side of a totem pole. And I pulled the adult's coat and I said, "What's that box back there?" He goes, "That's for the ashes for the person that they had the memorial for, like a chief or somebody higher up in the clan." Anyways, when we built these and put these up, we always let it dry out. So you'll see some cracks here and there in the red cedar. When we put it out in the rain, though, the rain would absorb into the wood and close some of these cracks. One bad thing about that, though, the water will stay in the middle of the log. And about 80 years from now, when it starts rotting, it'll rot from the inside out. So you won't know until parts of the totem pole fall off or the pole starts falling. One example, last year I was doing another tour in another village, Saxman, where I grew up. My mom lives there. Little old lady got lost. I looked up at one of the totem poles and the guy was lying to the side. By the time they got the boom up there, it fell to pieces. So that's the example of rotten from the inside out. Anyways, when we put these up, we put a creosote log about 8 feet in the ground, maybe a concrete base, and then about 8 feet out of the ground. And we bolt the totem pole there and keep it off the ground about a foot. So we wouldn't be touching the wet ground because it rots faster that way. And then we put an A-frame on the back side there. We actually, when we put these totem poles up, when we invite the whole community, not to take pictures, but to lift. We may need 80 people for the lift this one. And we'll lift it, set it down where that creosote log is, and then put guide ropes on the top, throw those guide ropes over the A-frame in the back, and get about 40 people on each rope and pull until that totem pole raises and hits that A-frame. Then we bolt it in. Then we have what they call a potlatch, name of this park. Potlatch is something that takes a couple of years for people to build up, whoever hosts it, because you have to feed and house maybe, like in the old days, hundreds of people.